Alright, welcome back to Super Ultra Budget Magic Online, playing BudgeTron in Modern. I'm pretty excited about this deck. It's a lot of fun to play. A lot of raw power. This is definitely a keepable hand. The curve is really lower to the ground than a lot of Tron decks. And that's fine. Big part of what you're trying to do is to make it more difficult for your opponent to cast their spells. Stuff like Thorn of Amethyst and Lodestone Golem makes that difficult for them. And then you got the huge value out of the colorless Eldrazi creatures. Many of those are pretty affordable to get online. I'll go ahead and pass turn here. Go get myself a mine. Faster in there. So that's going to put me up to 7. That's enough to cast both of my 3 drops or a 5 drop. I think the better option would be 3 drops initially, maybe. And it's possible that I draw a 4 drop in the meantime, which can be squeezed in. A drop that can be squeezed in. Okay. My opponent is tapped out, messing with their graveyard. I actually do have some graveyard hate in my sideboard. Looks like we're going to game 2. I guess they weren't happy with what they drew. So we'll go to the board. I'm not positive, but I think that they're trying to do graveyard shenanigans. So I will bring in Tormod's Crypt. And what do I want to take out? Nothing. Yeah, that's right. I don't want to take anything out. Take out Ugin. Got a pretty decent mix of lands, so I'll leave the Sundering Titan in. I'm going to take out Kozilek. And Platinum Angel. And I will take out one Spirit Guide. We'll give that a shot. The stuff I'm taxing is non-artifact and non-creature spells. And they had a decent number of those. This is a really terrible hand, so I'm actually going to mull. A Thorn of Amethyst and a Spirit Guide and a land. This is excellent. An expedition map. Yeah, that's nice too. We'll leave that right on top. Watery Grave. Raven's Crime. Okay. So I have to discard something. And they'll be doing that again very soon. So I'm going to play my mine. And I'm going to tap it. Exile. Thorn of Amethyst. And just from there. Drowsy Temple. So they're going to make me discard something. All right, I've got to pay two to cast it because of my own thorn. Well. Waste not. Discards a creature card, create a zombie. Another thorn. That's actually pretty cool. So let's go ahead and get this out. And I'm going to I want them both, but I think that the Thorn of Amethyst is the priority here. That's going to make it really difficult for my opponent to play Magic, because I'm not seeing a whole lot of creature cards. Discards land, add 2 mana whenever they discard a non-creature, non-land card, draw a card. Okay. That's fine. It's going to cost them all their mana to cost them to one draw. If I'm reading that correctly. Nice! I can start to further tax them, because I'm not seeing a lot of artifacts from them either. So I have not played a land yet for this turn. Pay 2. 1. Tower. Play land. That gives me 2 mana, and it would take 3 for an expedition map. Draws a card, then discards a card. What do I want to discard? He gets a zombie if I discard a creature. I can't afford to cast this for a little while. So we will let him have a little value off of Waste Not. not all that worried about him pinging me to death with zombies. He's managed to get all the way up to 4 lands. A noble effort. Come at me, bruh. Are you swinging with the zombie? Guess not.
Ooh, helm of the host.
Sweet. I love that card. Okay, so expedition map's going to cost me 3 to cast. 1, 2, 3. Then I can't even afford to crack it on the same turn because I've taxed myself so far. That's okay. It's just activating this. Shaper's so much value. But I want the other ones too. He can't afford to even cast any of his spells, it looks like. So I do want that lodestone golem. I want the helm of the host because it's so much value. So I'm going to let my opponent have another zombie. Why he didn't swing at me with the zombie last time. We'll see if he does this time. Maybe he's trying to do something different besides winning. He intends to win by attacking me in some way besides my life total. I don't know. Wistful thinking. Target player draws 2 cards, then discards. Crap. That sucks, but I do have a Seagate Wreckage at least. And I've got that Expedition map, both of which are very helpful. So, rather than discarding 4 cards, I am going to exile this. Discard. Can I not exile it in response? Maybe not, because I already drew cards as part of the thing, so I guess I don't know how to get it to do it, if it would even be legal. I don't know a good way to call a judge. So my opponent gets some value off of that. Unfortunately. So they can just suck it. Declare blockers, choose blockers. That's fine. I've got an Urza's Mine here. So, I can unload the Urza's Mine, use that, but they may be able to make me discard something in the meantime. Or, I can go get a power plant, get one land out. We'll activate this. I'm on a power plant. past turn. That way, if they make me discard, then I can draw at their end step off of Seagate Wreckage. If that makes sense. Destroy target non-basic land. Okay. So much for having Tron. And my opponent is up to 8 creatures. It's not on the battlefield. Alright, so I gotta get something here. And Tormod's Crypt. Looks like that was not what I was going for. Oh, it's 2 extra. Awesome. 1 and 2. It's only 5 cards in the graveyard. They do have Raven's Crime. I don't remember how Retrace works. And it's not spelling it out for me. So for now, I will pay 3. Draw a card. Revoker. Non-land card name. Activated abilities. Can't be activated. Okay, he's got me. Let's go to game 3. So I don't think Tormod's Crypt was actually helpful. Now I understand a little better what he's trying to do with some smallpoxy action or whatever. And so it actually does look very good to have Orbs of Warding looks awesome. And Ratchet Bomb. Waste Not, and we can dump Tormod's Crypts and bring back the Simeon Spirit Guide. Kozilek, nah. GPG, nah. Platinum Angel, nah. Ugin. Do I want Ugin? That would get rid of Waste Knots as well. But I have to get Tron together first. We'll try this. Let's see where it gets us. Be on the play. This is Waste Tower map. This is doable. Maybe not the best start ever, but it's something. So land map. Pass turn. Shaper. That looks great. last turn there. Draw another Tron piece so that I'll know what to do with my expedition map. Or another expedition map. At least not that already. Okay. And I'll draw the temple, then any extra land would get me a reality smasher and I could start doing some damage. Do I spend my expedition map on land? I'm going to do it. One, for whatever reason that I seem to draw the least, is a power plant. I don't know, I think I draw them all the same amount. Whatever, so now I've got that. And swing with the matter reshaper. Sweet. Alright, so that's 8. That allows me to do some big busted stuff. I don't want my opponent to be able to target me, so we'll put out Orbs of Warding. Then we'll put out a Lodestone Golem. Start taxing my opponent. And we'll swing. I think fate is actually going to help me more than it helps my opponent at this point. Tower and the power plant for a reality smasher. We'll go to combat and swing hard. Why is that not turning red? Why you gotta freeze up on me like that? There we go. Collective Brutality. Drowsy Temple is revealed. Put it onto the battlefield or my hand. Yeah, battlefield. I've got myself another Lodestone Golem. And we'll start taxing my opponent some more. It's not quite enough to kill him outright, but more pressure on the opponent, and I think we've got a pretty easy game 3 win. One knife to you.